Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, I am your girl Taylor Elizabeth. If you haven't hit that notification bell or that subscribe button, it's okay. I'll give you a moment to hit that right now. There you go. So you can know when your girls is dropping new videos. I mean, I think that's kind of important. So what are we talking about today? Well, my baby cousin has left the nest. And what I mean by that, she's gone to college. And she's going to MTSU in Murfreesboro. And if you know where that is, you're probably like, Taylor, you live in Memphis. It's only 3 hours away. That's not that far. But that's pretty far considering, like, she ain't been too many places, especially not by herself. So all I kept thinking was, what advice would I give myself if I was a freshman? Like, what advice do I think a freshman could use, or just a college student in general, what could they use? What advice could they use? So then I hit up some of my friends and my family members, and I was like, give me the tea. If you could do it again, what would you do different, and what would you tell yourself as a freshman? Excuse me. So I have a list from some of our family members and some of my friends, and we're gonna go through that list, and then I'm gonna tell you what I think and what my advice will be. So let's start off. Your mom, Tiffany, which is my auntie, she said, don't procrastinate. Take advantage of networking. It's okay to go to some parties, but stay away from after parties and the after party. Now, if you've been to college, you know what she mean by that. Because I never forget one night, we went to a party, and then after that, we went to an after party at somebody's house. And then after that, we left and went to IHOP. And by the time we was done with all that, y'all, it was 5 o'clock in the morning. And I'm sitting here like, the sun is coming up. Why are we still out? And we got class in the morning. Like, that didn't even make sense. So, it's okay to party sometimes. But we're not going to every party. And we're not about to be out here going to the after party and the after party. It ain't even that crucial. Then my auntie said, don't go anywhere without a friend or a group of people. Bruh. Listen, the fact that I made sure that I didn't go anywhere by myself when I was in college really saved my life in a couple of situations. We may have to do a YouTube about that, about my college experience, because it's nothing but the grace of God that I'm still sitting right here to talk to y'all, honestly. And she also said, if you are sexually active, don't sleep around because it shows. That's very true. I'm not going to lie. That's so true. I'm not gonna say that like I slept around, because that I didn't sleep around, but I know some other people that did sleep around in college, and you get a name, and you don't want that. Like, just how you would get a name if you was in high school, you get the same name in college, and that's not good at all, especially when you're there to complete your goals and to get yourself up out of here and do something with your life. And when you think back on college, I mean, it don't matter that much, but while you're in college, you just don't want that label. So just, if you was me, just keep your legs closed. It ain't even worth it, sis. One of my friends said, actually take advice from your mentor or seniors before you. Okay, I didn't really have any senior friends when I was in college, but as far as like mentors, I didn't have those either. But my mentor really was my mama. And that's kind of hard, especially when your mama your mentor, because you're looking like, bro, you just saying this because you my mama, not really, you don't know, because it's different now than it was in your time. It really ain't that much different. I'm just going to be real. Like, people playing the same games, they're doing the same things. Like, it's just that we're just in a different age and we have more technology. Other than that, it's about tit for tat. So, Katie, and to all of my other college students out here, if you have somebody in your corner that is trying to help you, listen to them. You want to know why? Because they're not, more than likely, they're not telling you something just to run their mouth. They're telling you something because they know, because they've experienced it. And what is my biggest thing that I say all the time? I'm here not just so I can be great, so that I can help you be great. And if somebody's trying to give you advice, listen, because more than likely, they've been through it and they're trying to help you not go through it. So turn your ears on. Don't let it go in one ear out the other ear. Listen. All right. One of my other friends said, don't procrastinate. Reach out to your professor. Listen. That is very important. First of all, don't procrastinate. We're going to get to that at the end when I talk about my stuff that I want to talk about. But reaching out to your professors, that is very important. Like, if you're not understanding an assignment, if you just need clarification, if you have any questions, they gave you that email for a reason. And some professors even give you their number. Use it. Use it. And I'm going to tell you why. You need to use it because if you don't know something and you were in class and then you go back to your dorm room and you really not understanding, you never know. Just because you contacted your professor, he may give you grace on your next exam and give you some extra points. Trust me, I've seen it happen for me and for some other people. Use the professor at your disposal. Contact them if you need help. Then she said, beat the deadline, don't let it beat you. Now, that should be a quote. I never heard that one before, but that is very true. Write all of your assignments out. Like, write them out so you can know when your due date is. And don't procrastinate, which means don't wait till the night before to do an assignment, a whole paper, and you know it's due tomorrow. Like, don't do that. And trust me, I know everybody says this. I do my best work at the last minute. I mean, I have done some really good work at the last minute, but when I think back on it, the stress that I was in, the anxiety that I had, the bald spots that I had because I was pulling my hair out because my anxiety was so high, because I was waiting at the last minute, we could have dealt without. So don't wait to the last minute. Beat the deadline and don't let it beat you. Then my other friend said, don't depend on anyone but yourself. That's a good one too, especially don't depend on anyone in college. One, y'all all in the same, y'all going through the same stuff. And people can really let you down. And I know how Katie is, and I know how I am as well. We're kind of the same with it. Like, when somebody tells they're gonna do something and we looking for them to do it and they don't do it, we really just be hurt. Like, why would you even tell me you was gonna do that? So if, Katie, you can't call us and we can't do it, then it really don't need to be done. I'm just going to let you know. Don't depend on the people over there. You got us. We're your support system. So to my other college people out there, you need a support system. Don't just be out here depending on people that, like, they're useless. You need a real stable support system. So you may not have, I know sometimes people don't have good relationships with their family, but you need a good support, a very good support system. That is, when I tell y'all that's key in college, it is so key. God is so key. All right, my other friend said, just because your friends are partying and procrastinating doesn't mean that you do the same. Exactly, like that's really self-explanatory. Just because your little friend over here is like, girl, we about to go to the club. Come on, girl, we gotta go. Like, so soon I'm gonna be there. You know they cute. I know, but I gotta do my work. It's okay to say, no, not this time. I'll get up with y'all later, okay? Because you know what? I know they say C's get degrees, but trust me, that A or that B looks a whole lot better on that GPA than a C does. So, keep the important stuff in your focus. I wish somebody would have said that to me. Because when I was in college, I was so focused on this man. That made me no good. Missed out on a lot of stuff because I'm trying to put him in the front. When really, I'm there to get an education. I'm there to make myself better, not be stuck on some man. Like, so keep the things that are important, which is school, being involved in your relationship with God, and bettering yourself. Those things, that's the only thing that's important right now. Ain't no relationship important. We ain't focused on that. Those things that I just said, that's what's important. One of my mentors, and she's my mentor, but we're the same age. I mean, you can have a mentor that's the same age. Her name is Juliana. I love her. She said, never rush the process. College is an experience that helps mold you in ways you don't realize. Bro, that is so true. College is, when people say college isn't for everybody, I understand that. But going to college is so much more than just doing work. It's the experience of being in college. Like, the experience that I got in college, I wouldn't trade for anything because I know how to communicate with people better. I know how to listen to other people who have different opinions and backgrounds better. I know how to be in a diverse environment. But not even just that. Like, you're there. Like, don't try to make speed this up, because trust me, baby. Post-graduation, life is ghetto. I wish somebody would have, like, really prepared me for this, because this is real ghetto. So enjoy your time on that campus. Do as much as you can that your money will allow you, that your family will allow you. Enjoy the process. Do not rush it. Like, I ain't gonna lie. I slick wish I could go back. Just tab it. So enjoy your process. And she also said, make the grades from the jump or you will be playing catch up. Now listen, that's what I'm talking about. When folks be like, C's, you probably gonna hear this while you there. C's get degrees. Don't get me wrong, they do. But you would rather much have an A or a B than a C, D, or F. Because listen, all it takes is for one D, one F, and boom, your GPA will drop. Like, and when I tell you, it is so hard to raise your GPA back up. It's as easy. It's so easy for it to drop, but I really don't understand. So my people out there that work at colleges, help us understand it. Why is it so easy for it to drop, but it's not so easy for us to get it back up? But that's okay. We ain't even gonna worry about that, because you know why? We're not gonna be at every party. We're gonna make sure that our head is in the book and not focus on some little boy or little girl. And we're going to have our priorities together. So we don't even need that advice. Don't even worry about it. And my brother said, he gave some really good advice. I wish I would have known, thought about some of these things too. Don't be afraid to make friends. Okay. I ain't going to lie. My freshman year, it was pretty rough. Because I was really scared to make friends. And then a lot of people didn't talk to me because, I mean, they just were, a lot of people were judgmental. And they just assumed that I was this light-skinned stuck-up girl. But then once you get to know me, it's like, oh my gosh, you're so cool. I thought you was the B-word, but you really not, girl. Well, thanks. So, don't be afraid to make friends. Put yourself out there. Go to groups. Talk to people in your dorm room. Go to events. Like, just show up. It's other people there that don't have no friends. You ain't got no friends. Mingle. Like, it don't hurt to just spark a conversation. Don't be in a rush for a relationship. Listen, my brother dropping tea, knowledge, gems over here. Because when I tell you, that is so key. Especially as you're fresh in your freshman year, do not be in a rush to get in a relationship. Most of the time, they don't really last anyway. But this is a big transitional period, going from high school to college, going from you have to abide by all your parents' rules to now you can do whatever you want and they really can't tell you much. Because I mean, more than likely you're away from college, you're away from home, or you live on campus. So like, it ain't too much they can tell you. And also you're over the age of 18. So this is a big transitional period, and also beginning to learn who you are. Because if you think about it, as kids in high school, everything that we did up to college was what our parents told us, what they said we could do, what they said we could eat, what they said, where we said we could go. So like, now you're in college, it's almost like this is the time to discover who you truly are. Because all the other times we was just doing stuff because our parents said it. But just because this is the time to discover who you really are, don't mean just go out there, try everything, baby. Everything don't need to be tried, trust me. Because if I could take some things back, I ain't gonna lie, I kind of would. I would not have smoked weed. It wasn't worth it. Like, it caused more harm than good to me. So yeah, don't be in a rush to be in a relationship. Trust me, relationships will always be there. This time right now where you're single, you're not married, you don't have no kids, you don't really have a lot of obligations, this is the time right now to focus on you. Just you. Be selfish. I wish I would have known that when I was in college. Be selfish with your time. Now I'm making up for it and now I'm being selfish, but I wish that's something that I would have known. Find a church and build a relationship with God. That is very key, because without God, nothing is truly possible. And you need him. I'm learning that now. That is something that I'm working on now. And I wish I would have known when I was in college. Like, I grew up in church, go to church every Sunday. But then once I got to college, it was just like, I ain't going to church. That wasn't nothing but the devil. Nothing but the devil. Like, what, fool? You know you need to be in church. You know the enemy wants your mind. Sit your butt down in somebody's pew. So go to church. Begin to have built your own relationship with God, not just because you had to go to church as a kid. Like, now you have a choice what church you want to go to. These are things that is important. So, Katie, please find a church home. And if you don't, if you can't find one, I'm about to start looking up one because I want you to go to church, Katie. I really do. It's going to help you. It really is. But you know that. And I'm going to probably buy you a Bible. So just stay tuned for that too, Katie. The next one is go to class. Half of the grades come from attendance. Bro, this is so true. And I'm going to tell you how I know this is true because I've had plenty of classes where all you had to do was go in the class and sign the roll. Like, they barely taught anything. If they did teach anything, I mean, I really wasn't paying attention. That's not what I'm telling you to do. But if you weren't there when you signed the roll, and if, when they go back to see that you weren't there, basically you get a zero for the day. So then when it comes down to exams or you need help and you're trying to figure out why your professor is being a butthole and they're not trying to help you, well, remember, you barely came to class. So why should they help you? You didn't do what they needed you to do. Now you want them to do something for you. That's not how it works. So take y'all butts to class. And I mean it. All right. My other friend said, do homework before going out and remember the things your parents taught you. That's so true. Because I ain't gonna lie, when I got to college, I did my work before going out for the most part. But when it comes to remembering things that my parents taught me, yeah, it kind of like went out the window. Just about. Like, I just was like, I'm free! Wow! Like, freedom. And freedom is good, but we also need to have, like, balance. And, I can't think of the word. Priorities. I think that may be the word. Priorities. But you need to, like, remember the things, Katie. This is for Katie. Remember the things that your mom has instilled in you, and my mama, and my daddy, your Uncle Carlos, and Nanny. Like, think about all the things that they have taught you throughout life, and don't forget about those, because those are key. Especially because you're going to be around a lot of people in college who weren't raised like you. They weren't raised like you. And it's not just okay, this for y'all too, this in college. You're gonna be around people that weren't raised like you. So, like, you need to hold true to those morals and values that you were raised on. Because trust me, they can really help you be a better person. My other friend said, focus on being early, not on time. So basically, we can use it for an assignment. So if assignment is due on Friday, let's try to get that assignment in by Wednesday or Thursday. So when Friday come, we ain't already did that. Like, we ahead of the game, baby. Or we can look at it as being on time for class. Like, some professors will lock their doors. So if your class starts at 12 and you get there at 12:01, oops, sorry, the class may be locked. You can't get in. But if you was there early, got your seat, you wouldn't be worried about those type of things. And then last thing for my friend, he said, be intentional about your future. And I'm going to hold that one until the end when I talk about what about my list. So, here is now my list. Your first group of friends are usually not your real friends. Most of the time, when you first get on college campus, you don't have no friends. They don't have no friends. Let's link, girl. And then you start learning each other. And you're like, yeah, this ain't it. But you only made them friends out of the fact that y'all both knew and y'all didn't have anybody. And that's okay. Like, you need somebody in the beginning. But mostly everybody that I know, their first group of friends did not last long. Like, at all. Write down all your due dates in your planner so you can plan ahead. Focus on being early, not on time, which is the same thing that my friend said. I had a planner. I'll show you. Because now I do this in my grown-up life. Where I hate that I waited until my senior year to do this, but it would have helped me. So in your planner, you have the month where it has the whole month. Go ahead and write down when every assignment is due, what time is due in all these blocks. So that every day when you're looking at it, you can say, okay, well, this assignment is due on this day. All right, I already did that. Put a check mark by it or cross it out because you'll know you already did it. This will, like, use your planner. It will help you stay on top of things. Don't be sitting here trying to remember everything in your brain. Like, you're going to have too many classes to do all that.
Go to class. Go to class. I don't care if the class is super boring. This ain't what you really want to learn about. Go to class. Because in the end, when you need the extra, them extra points, you need the extra help, you want the professor to spend some extra time with you. Like I told you, if you wasting their time and you not coming to class, don't expect them for them to do anything in return for you. Go to class. Go to class, Katie. Go to office hours. In your syllabus, it will tell you what is the professor's office hours or where you can email them. Some of them they give their cell phone numbers out, like I told you. Use it. Use it, use it, use it, use it. It's so many times where I wish I would have used the professor's office hours to get a better understanding, and I didn't. And then I go take the test, and I'm like, bruh, I really studied, but I didn't really understand what I was studying, so how did I think I was going to get an A or a B? Shoot, maybe even a C. So use the office hours. Sit in the first two rows of class. When I tell y'all, first of all, I knew about this one, but I didn't do it until senior year. Like a dummy. Because when you're first getting in college and even when you're just there, a lot of times you'd be like, bro, I do not want to sit in the first two rows of class. Like, I do not want this professor looking at me. I really don't want to be here. Then I'm up here with these lame kids. I know that's probably what you're thinking. But if you think about it, if you sit in the first two rows, you're less likely to be on your phone. You're less likely to be shopping on Fashion Nova, H&M, Zara, all them other places. You're less likely to be sitting there watching Grey's Anatomy and Law & Order on Netflix if you sit in the first two rows of class. Because why? The professor is right there. But the further back you get, that's when you're going to start. You starting to be on probably FaceTime, watching TV, online shopping. And then you trying to figure out, well, why you got an F4D. Well, look, think about it. You're sitting all the way back there. You're not even paying attention. So sit in the first two rows, little girl, and everybody else that's out there. Because when I tell you, it really makes a difference. I didn't think that it would, but it really does. Because you're less likely to be distracted. Be mindful of your surroundings. And that is just like for safety precautions. When you're on the campus, when you're going out, especially when you're away from home, and this is a city that you're not too familiar with, like my auntie said, go places with a group or just not by yourself with somebody else. But be mindful of your surroundings at all time. Because when I tell y'all, stuff happened to me in high school, but in college, I'm really going to have to do a YouTube on just my college experience. That's when I became watchful of my surroundings, because people would like try to jump me. They would be plotting on me, just hating the devil, just letting the devil make a monkey out of them. But my auntie gave me that same advice: be watchful of your surroundings so you can know what's going on at all times. And that's very helpful. So yeah, be mindful. Probably need to go get some mace or a taser. Start with mace first. All of y'all out there, go get you some mace so you can be strapped up. This one's a little funny to me. Okay. If you have hopes of going Greek, do not sleep with anyone that is Greek. Now, my mentor, aka my mother, told me this before I went to college. But I was like, yeah, whatever. And I'm not saying that, like, I wanted to go Greek and this caused me not to go Greek. That's not what I'm saying. But what I am saying is just don't do it. Because it'll get around, and then like you will want to do something and then people may not pick you, or they just may be petty because of it. Like, just don't do it. Stay away from Greeks and athletes. It's a no. Like, it's a no. It's a no for me. Okay? Just stay away from them. Like, just stay away. I don't even know how to like say that in any other way besides no. If you're gonna try to date somebody, go for an engineer, go for a pre-med, pre-law, a business major, chemical, like chemistry. I don't know, but just don't date a Greek or athlete. Like, don't mess around with them. Like, just don't put yourself in this situation. Just don't do it, okay? Take it from my advice. Relations will always be there. This is the time to be selfish. Like I told you, like, this is the time that, first of all, you can never get this time back. Never. It's a lot of things that I wish I could change, but it's a lot of things that I'm so happy that I did while I was in college. So just wait for the relationship. Honestly, senior year maybe. We could wait maybe senior year, really after, honestly. But relationships are not all of that. Focus on you. Get your work, get your degree, because we got things to do. We got a bag to secure. We don't need to be in college 6, 7, 8 years still working on an undergrad. Like, no, we need to be in four, get out. Like, it's time to roll. Like, we got other things to accomplish. Make God a priority. I wish I would have done it. Like, honestly, I really wish I would have, because I feel like that would have helped me gain wisdom and understanding and discernment, so I would have known who to hang around with and how to move when I was in college. So if you make God a priority and you put him first and acknowledge him in all your ways, he will direct your path. So do that. But so you can know, like, nah, this ain't it. Nah, we don't need to go over there. That's not it for me. You need, like, God can help you with that. So if you put him first, he can give you wisdom. He can give you discernment. So you'll be able to make wise choices. Say no to drugs. I wish I would have never smoked weed. I don't care what anybody says. You can definitely get addicted to weed. How do I know? Because I was definitely addicted to weed. Don't do drugs. Like, you don't know what these folks putting in this stuff. Don't do it. Just stay away from it. If you choose to drink alcohol, do not drink any drink that you did not see anybody make. Don't do it. Like, if you didn't see anybody make that drink, we're not drinking it. I don't care if somebody, oh, well, I bought you a drink. I'm straight. Don't, thank you, but I'm not interested. Thank you. That's what we're going to say. Go to counseling. Look at me, little girl. You hear me. Go to counseling. That's for the rest of y'all, too. Go to counseling. I know at University of Memphis, counseling was free. If I'm not mistaken, I think you got like 6 sessions a semester. I don't know. It's probably different at every university. I don't know, but I just know at my university, it was free. That's essential. This is a big change in your life, big transition. A lot of things are going to happen. Like, when people say college was hard, it's not necessarily because of the work. Because college to me personally, it wasn't because of the work. The work wasn't hard to me. It was managing college and life at the same time. Like, because before this, you didn't have to manage your life. Your mother and your dad managed your life. Now you're in the driver's seat. You're managing your life. So I think that is what makes it hard. And going to counseling can help you figure out how to navigate this new area of your life. So please go to counseling. I don't care what anybody tells you. I don't care if they say, well, people that go to counseling are crazy. If that's the case, we all crazy. Shoot, because we all could use some counseling. Go to counseling. Last but not least, and I feel like this is one of the most important things besides making God a priority, is prepare for life post-college. And what do I mean by that? I mean, do everything that you can to set yourself up that once you graduate, you can land a job or you're going to grad school. Like, you need to have a plan for what does post-graduation look like. A lot of us didn't have a plan. And I'll be honest, I was one of those people. When I got close to graduating, like, my anxiety was so high. Oh my God, it was so high, because I'm just thinking, like, bro, every area of my life I've always known was next. Graduate, you leave elementary, you go to middle school. Leave middle school, you go to high school. You leave high school, you go to college. Okay, I'm leaving college, but what is next? It's so many things that I wish, when it comes to this area, I wish that I would have done different. I wish I would have gotten more internships. I wish I would have put myself out there more on my university and got more involved and networked. That's very important. I wish I would have volunteered more. But all of those things together can help you be successful in your post-graduation life. I'm not saying that I'm not successful, because, baby, y'all better get ready, because some big things are in store for Taylor Elizabeth. Not saying that, but I'm just saying that I feel like it would have been a lot easier if I really put some real effort behind being prepared for post-graduation life. But it's okay, because y'all are going to do great, because you just watched this video and I've given you some bomb advice from me, my family, and my friends. And Kaylee, you're definitely going to do great, because you got a whole support system and we're not going to let you fail. You got this. I'm so proud of you. for deciding to go to MTSU and leave the nest. I'm scared, but I'm excited. I love you, Katie, so much. If you need anything, if you just want to talk, if you want to vent, if you need help with writing a paper, if it's late and you need somebody to help you study, call me. Like, I didn't really have anybody because in my family, I'm the first grandchild. I'm the oldest. So it was me. Like, all I had was really me. But Katie, you don't just have you. You got me, you got my brother, you got TT, you got your uncle, you got your mama, you got Nanny, you got Mun. You got a whole support system. Try not to cry. I miss you so much. I love you. Okay, I'm trying to get myself together. You're gonna do great. You're gonna be great. You're gonna be okay. We miss you. I love you. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share. And of course, until next time, bye.